favourites. Now, with the rain around, not really sure who this favours, but certainly Glenelg have the bigger bodied. They're a little bit taller as well, so maybe a slim little advantage with the rain around and the heavy conditions for the Eagles today.
Set to go. Undefeated Glenelg 10-0 up against second place Eagles here, and it's expected to be a really tight contest. Cheetahs just bumped off the ball there. First kick forward from Agnew to get the Bays inside. They're attacking 50. Pink couldn't control it. Gefrida, knocked down, taking the kick, was impacted. And came back to Brad Agnew, who fires it high ball. And well done, reading it nicely. Thompson comes out full chest and takes the mark. And now he's got some availability.
He's averaging 26 touches a game, sends it back where it came. And Gefrida's going to take things out of defence. From the other side, he was looking for McFarlane, couldn't gather it. So the Tigers with a chance back in. Darcy Bailey's kick is red hot and has hit Marlon Motlop.
Motlop here has been in some pretty good form as well recent times. Gettable shot from that pocket.
Yeah, he's been a journeyman, Marlon Motlop, and this kick is really good to start for the Tigers. They draw first play. Sharking it up, Stengel. Quickly around the corner, it's going to fall nicely. Cheetahs sends it over to Mutch, and he runs towards an open goal and drives it through the middle. Now the Eagles have got one.
And Riley Knight had three apiece also.
Coming through Bailey, just losing his feet there. Maybe a little clip around the ears. He is. He's going to get a free kick here. Normally makes the most of his opportunities. Almost going at a goal a game. Bailey, and he drives this one through. So they're out by 6 points now, the base.
And you have to say, at this point in time, they're looking more settled.
Ball going forward. Oh, Hayes impacts the contest after Martini sent it forward. Another whistle. He's kicked goals in 9 of his 10 appearances this season, Liam McBean. From 45, likes it off the boot. Goal umpire didn't have to move much at all. The Tigers have got 3 of the first 4. Biggest silver mine in the world at one stage, I'll have you know. But that's another story. Durden forced to go double-fisted, close to the boundary line. Oh, suggestion of a high tackle there as well from Dylan Land. And it is going the way of Zane Williams.
Biggles, don't poke the Casey Bear.
Oh, it's good. Good to throw a little bit of bait out, isn't it?
Member of the Eagles Reserves Premiership last year. Goal kicker in his last game and a goal kicker against the Tigers as well when they played earlier this year. And from a very tight angle,
oh, wow.
He's done an outstanding job as Zane Williams spreads the needle.
What a kick from there. Hardly any daylight.
Glenelg thought he was holding the ball. It's good work from McCarthy there. Hayes just bounces into Durden. Well, that's a suggestion of a high tackle there as well. And in these conditions, there is always the opportunity that that's going to happen. We've already seen 2 goals kicked from free kicks. Multiple goal kicker his last 2 games against the Tigers. Hayes comes forward, lights it off the boot, and Woodville West Torrens take the lead for the first time in the game.
Looking for Jungfa, he's got it, gives it to Gussie Poole, as Kay said, back in the side today, good to see him here. And here's Cheetahs from 55, just launches up, and a free kick has been found, just held as he was going forward. There was Menzel, and probably into the back as well. It was a 2-for-1.
Umpires have had a fair bit to say today, and there's going to be a 25 paid after a conversation as well. That'll bring him right to the goal face.
Well, it looked like the free kick was there, certainly, for the hold.
Yep.
It was actually his own man that cannoned into him into the back, but there we go. Dan Menzel able to slot one through for the Eagles, and out by 7 points.
It's going to fall short. Sam Rowland had it, slipped through his fingers. Cheetahs hasn't stopped trying, charging out. And the low ball comes in now from Brett Turner. Motlop, he's got a bag of tricks. He's got a big bag of tricks, and one of them is kicking a very nice goal. Motlop comes up with a finish to get his second.
That's Brett Turner's kick. A high ball, 2-on-1. McBean in the sandwich there. Getting around Bradley. Clever little handball. His kick is absolutely fantastic. I think it's Reed Puller that has nailed it. And he has.
High ball beyond Lonigan. Cutting across here is a chance for Sam Durden. Almost nutmegged Pudney there. Lonergan again. Hand pass over the top. Well done, Riley Knight. Finds Menzel, who kicks around the body. It was an intelligent kick as well, and he found Jack Ferns just hovering in front of Chris Curran.
Two better players. We now see Pudney pushing forward also.
Not his strong suit kicking for goal. He hasn't kicked one this season. Well, it was worth waiting for when he finally did, as Jack Ferns gets the goal to put the Eagles in front.
Working hard in those conditions, and Cheetahs, well, he's done it beautifully, and he was terrific last year when he crossed halfway through for the Eagles, ended up playing in a flag as Stengel gets swung around. Here's Joey Sinor's got enough time to set the kick and bang it through the middle, and just what they needed. The Eagles are out.
Inside their attacking 50 now, Matty Snook. Shallow entry though, and Reynolds appear to be held. And it's free kick going the way of the Tigers. Here's Seymour just caught behind there. And this is the danger of giving away that 25 in the middle of the ground. As you can see, obviously, Pierce Seymour. Eagles on top by 7 points. And Reynolds with a heavy ball. A lot of breeze. The scoring end. He unloads. Got a good piece of it, Luke Reynolds. Oh, that's a terrific finish as Reynolds comes up with the first of the day. Interesting hand pass, Durden, Bradley, about to be run down. Stengel got him, dispossessed him. Umpire said play on. Is McFarlane again. Gets it out to Cheetahs. He's got numbers ahead of him. They're queuing up here at the moment and going back with the flight of the ball. Riley Knight's taken the mark. Distance won't be a problem. The accuracy is going to be the real test here.
Kicked a lot of goals from here, Riley Knight. And they come out of the change rooms, of course, every training session. This is the spot. Bolts out, but to kick the first goal of this final term, this is massive.
We know he's a high quality player, 55 AFL games with the Crows, 9 goals, 5 this season. That's just keeping it low and slicing it through the middle, and the Eagles enjoy a 7-point lead.
Carlton straight after this game, Andrew McPherson has just been confirmed as the medical sub in that match. And Big Jack Hannah has, well, managed to keep himself reasonably clean today so far. Gets the clearing kick out. Beacon slaps it forward. And a free kick is going to go against Knight. A little overexcited there with that tackle. Have a look at that again.
Sure is.
There's a real tension in this game. You could feel it coming out in the, since the second half started.
That statewide super replay, look, the tackle was legitimate, but he's going to pay another 25 for the scuffle that broke out, which will bring the former skipper Bradley well within range.
Very capable. And just what the Tigers needed to make it tight again. It's back to a 1-point game.
Thompson, courage personified under enormous pressure there from Allen. And then the spin move out from Paul, but the Bays are going to end up with it again.
Lant driving for distance. McBean, front of the pack. He's got his hands on it. And a chance now for the leading goal kicker in the sample to go back. Trying to get his third this season. This to put Glenelg back in front. And he likes it off the boot. McBean makes no mistake. And the Tigers take the lead. And Lonergan's going to kick to a congested area. At half forward, Lomberto front position. Sharked nicely by Riley Knight. Keeps the ball low into the pocket. Well, Stengel draws a free kick here on Martini. Hasn't seen a lot of it, Tyson Stengel, but he can be dangerous. 15 goals this season for Stengel. And that is as good as it gets. Scores level.
Oh, what a kick. What a finish.
Clean pick up by Curran. Shoots it up. Yates around quickly to Bradley. He's got Stengel. Gets around him nicely and pops a kick into McBean. That was just great work from Andrew Bradley. He's really stood up in his last term directly in front. And with the game all square, Liam needs it and Liam gets it.
Both teams been in front in this fourth term. But right now, it's Glenelg by one straight kick, and one more might be enough. Even a point at this stage is going to be valuable. And it's Jack Yates going for distance. McBean, front position. Ball trickles over the back. Reynolds, did he get a boot on it? Right on the line. The goal umpire says, I'll have a think about it. Calling in both boundary umpires and the goal umpire and the field umpire. This could just about decide the game. All clear. It's a goal. Tigers lead it by 2 goals.
Well, good leadership from the umpires because they had to get it right.
Chance now on cue for Reynolds. The left footer rushing forward. Neat pass. Finds Bailey. And Bailey's slowing it right down here. He's got options. He played against the Eagles, which was back in round 2. They beat them by 29 points on that occasion. And Darcy Bailey for his second of the afternoon to put some icing on the cake. And the Tigers are heading for 11 consecutive wins.
This is just remarkable. Not only are they heading for 11 consecutive wins, but they're going to break the old Lavenue hoodoo where they haven't had much success. And
Paul again gets it. Gives it to Putney, and there's the siren. We've got our footy club, 11 wins on the trot. They haven't had a great record here at all. In fact, the Eagles have won 8 of the last 9 against them, so it is a huge win for the Tigers.